everyone. This is David Pegler. This is your pre-London outlook for July the 2nd. Bit of a non-farm payroll look ahead for the morning. Welcome to FX Bootcamp. Let me remind you, the purpose of FX Bootcamp is education. This is non-load service. Myself and none of the other currency coaches make any trade recommendations during the course of the day. However, what we will do is conduct some fundamental and technical analysis, hopefully help you put together some good positive trade plans. Please bear in mind that when you're trading heavily leveraged, occasionally this leverage will work for you. Unfortunately, more times than not, as a novice trader, has a horrible and inconvenient way of working against you. So please do not trade real money until you have a good proven track record of success using a demo account. Okay, well, it's a holiday week, or it's a shortened week. Mixed in with that is the morning's non-farm payroll release. Obviously very important. I actually think that I'm not much of a fundamentalist, but I actually think that this non-farm payroll is a little bit more eagerly expected than others. And quite frankly, it wouldn't surprise me to see a little bit worse than expected jobs number. So look out for that. Additionally, I'm not going to show you the chart, but we rejected late in the day on the equity markets today. So I want to see if that kind of precipitates itself through the market tomorrow, but it's already going to depend on non-farm payroll. So what I want to do, just moving forward, is because I don't think the London session is really going to offer up fantastic trading opportunities. You know, typically before non-farm payroll, it's really a bit of a wash anyway, and now just compounded by the fact it's a shortened and thinner week. So, what I'm going to do is take a look at the pound-related pairs, pound-dollar, pound-swissy, pound-yen, and we'll just take a little technical view of things and know our levels going into non-farm payroll tomorrow, and then however the market responds to it, we can trade from there and hopefully find some decent conservative trade plans. Okay, this is the let me take you to the daily pound dollar, and this is what we got. All right, this range tried to break. If you remember my last video, we were looking for breakout of this range, and it broke out nicely, and I actually lost a little bit of money trying to long this when it came back to retest the top of the trap. You know, every little bit of support level I was trying to long off of, and eventually I, went long, break even, until I started losing money on it, and finally got on the clue train to the short side. But, failed breakout to the top side, but now we've found support again at daily 21 EMA. And as long as this daily 21 here is in control, not to mention this little trend line pushing up here, as long as this support is in control, we have ourselves a beautiful trap situation between that daily 21 or this trend line and the support line at the top. Now, just to the 4 hour, that's quite a few pips if I just adjust this trend line to be a little more accurate. There we go. And, you can actually narrow this down even further and take a little bit of support if I grab a little horizontal line here. You know, you can clearly tell, look how many candles have not been able to close above and below the 64.20 area here. And that's our first little spot to the downside, and then you could say differently, you can trap the top side of this pound dollar with a little trend line. And I'm just trapping it technically to try and get some measure of what other traders are potentially seeing, because we do not have direction here, folks. Only a little bit of direction we have is the fact that we breached the previous swing low, but we did not close a candle below it. So, for a full directional change, we would have wanted to see something like this, and now continuation, and we might be in the midst of that continuation. So that's why I have defined the 64.24 area as my little breakout point. And if you're really conservative, you want to see 64 broken, the figure. I know that's 70 pips away, but I think you can wait. I think if we can break this solidly to the downside, there's going to be lots of pips, and 70 is really not that big of a deal, especially in the context of an eagerly awaited non-farm payroll. So, that's my little price trap on the pound. Below the 64 area, I'm really bearish, and above the 65.75, call it 65.50 area, I'm pretty bullish all the way to a double top. All right, so that's my little look at the pound dollar. Let's take a look at the pound Swissy. This has been the moneymaker of late. Much cleaner trade and, quite frankly, an old favorite of mine. Okay, this is, if I just take you to a daily, we've very, very clearly defined daily trend line holding price at the moment. In a lot of respects, the same as the pound, but, this thing's been picking a direction and intraday trending in that direction. So, if I zoom you in, though, and we've got a 4 hour here, you'll notice that we did not quite touch the trend line on a 4-hour level. But what we did do is find support on this corresponding swing higher here. So what I'm looking for now is a little pullback for further downside, and then this little trend line is the first stop. But if we can break that, I really like our chances of seeing 74.47. So, you know, based on the fact that we're making lower highs and lower lows now, you know, my bias remains to the downside. And, you know, I'm looking for reasons to short. And if you take a look at the hourly chart, you know, we can pop up a fib of the last major swing here. And, you know, I really like the short side of this at a retest of 78. If we can get there, 78 has been some very staunch support. And if we can make our way up there, I really like the short side of that. But I think the more likely scenario is that we tick on up to, say, this 77.70 area to 77.64. And then I'm looking for some continued downside. But given the fact that we've run into support here, you know, if we do bounce off this and higher low, then we're going up to the 78 area. But I still like the short side of the bias here. So, you know, even if we higher low off that 21 EMA on the hourly, I really think that the pound Swissy short at 78 in that region is pretty decent, you know, with a stop above the 618 up here, you know, kind of hiding a stop above these last swing lows here. I like our chances there. But yep, the short at 78 is a pretty clean, good-looking play in alignment with the prevailing trend. All right. Last but not least, pound yen. Taking our gander on all these pound-related pairs here. It's going to be a tricky day, though, folks. Make no mistake. It's not going to be plain sailing by any stretch of the imagination. What I'm looking at on the pound yen is a couple of things. One, you know, we were making a series of little higher lows and higher highs, and trying to make a little upside drift. But what you'll notice that we have failed to break this 159.50 area convincingly, and you know, several swing highs have struggled to get through here. They've been able to breach it and wick up to 160, but not sustain. This is a 4-hour pound yen chart, and not sustain anything above that. And what you'll notice now, if I zoom your way in, you'll notice now that we've actually failed the high again. We've made another lower high here. So, you know, we've lost direction on the pound yen completely. And if remember that a downtrend is a series of lower highs and lower lows, and an uptrend is a series of higher highs and higher lows. So when you're getting lower highs and higher lows, you have yourself, you know, classic consolidation, and there's really not a whole lot to do there in way of a trend following type trade plan. So the one observation we can make on the pound yen is this, is that we've been moving in these stages. You know, once we've been able to breach certain levels of support and resistance, you know, we've been able to move in little quadrants here. So, you know, 158.32 to 159.50. And if we break that, then it looks like we're going to 156.60. And if we break that, you know, down into the early 155. So it's kind of been moving in steps. And with the volatility of non-farm payroll, this is our trap. You know, the 4-hour 21 definitely in control. But a break and hold above 159.50 is bullish. And a break and hold below 158.32 is bearish. Okay, everything in between here, you're scalping, you're watching shorter term charts, you're taking what you can get, but nothing in the way of a directional type trade. All right, so there you go, guys. There's your pre-London outlook, little NFP preview, and a technical outlook on a lot of your favorite pound related pairs. So my name is David Pegler. Good luck tomorrow, and stay conservative, folks, and I'll catch up with everybody on Monday.